Sometimes a subject becomes more clear by examples. Another example, I become very sick, visit a doctor. The doctor examines me and then he writes a prescription on a piece of paper. Very happy, I come back home. I have great devotion towards my doctor. One must have devotion towards doctor, nothing wrong. But then this devotion turns into blind devotion. Then what happens? I place the picture of this doctor or the statue of this doctor on the altar. And then I bow down 3 times. And then I offer flowers and incense and sweets and lamps. And then I take out the paper, piece of paper, and start reciting 2 pills in the morning, 2 pills in the afternoon, 2 pills in the evening. I keep on reciting that. Madness. What again? Blind devotion does that only, nothing else. Mere madness. Second step. I again go to this doctor. Hey, what you wrote on this paper? How is this going to help me? Now I start using my intellect. And the doctor is an intellectual guy. And he tries to explain me. Well, look, this is your disease. And this is the root cause of your disease. And the prescription that I have written, if you take this medicine, it will eradicate the root cause. And once the root cause is eradicated, your disease is eradicated. Ah, wonderful. Look, my doctor is so intelligent. My doctor is wonderful. And I come back home. Still, I don't take any medicine. Now I keep on fighting with all the neighbors all around. My doctor is the best doctor. Doctors of you fellows, useless. The prescription that is given by my doctor is the real prescription. All other prescriptions are useless. One keeps on fighting. And this is what happens in the life, in the society. Every enlightened person, when he finds misery all around, people sick, because of the defilements in the mind, then out of love, out of compassion, he gives some prescription to the people. This medicine will help you. Take this Dhamma medicine and you will be out of misery. Time passes away. People forget to take medicine. They never take medicine. But they develop tremendous amount of attachment towards the founder of my religion. The founder of my religion is the real enlightened person, others are not. Is the real wise person, others are not. Is the real saintly person, others are not. And I keep on fighting with others without taking the medicine. Nobody takes medicine. And they keep on fighting, this sect with the other sect, this sect with the other sect. Such ignorance, such madness is because the Dhamma remains either at the first step of blind faith, are better than that, but still worse, is only at the intellectual level. But when one starts taking medicine, then it becomes bhavanamaya panya. Then you are having your own experience of Dhamma, and that will start benefiting you.